Guys, what is up? Welcome back to the video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make your own thumbnails. This is going to be 100% free. You need this software. It's called paint.net, and I'll show you guys how to get it right now. Okay guys, to get the program, you have to go to Google Chrome and then just type this link in, or just copy and paste. I'll have it in the description of my video, and then click on get it now, free download. Just click on the blue link and then look at the system specs. Make sure you have that, or it will still work, but that's a really low amount of specs. Just click on the .pdn download as shown, and then click on free download now on the top right of the screen. It should start a download on the bottom left. Just click on that, and then it should open up a WinRAR file. Then what you're gonna do is just click on the application file. Then ask you for the administrator permission. Just let it click yes, and then it should start the installation process. Once that's done, just wait for it to load, and then it should open up the paint.net. Just choose express, and I click I agree, then click next, and then it should start the installation process. I already have it downloaded, so that's all. Okay, now that you have got it, what you have to do is open it up like so, and then we're gonna do this thing. It's gonna be on the top left corner. It's gonna say new. Just click on that and make the width 1280 and make the height 720. I can't type today. And then you're gonna click OK. This will make a rectangle box, which will be easy for us to make it look better. And so then we're gonna find a cool background, which will make the thumbnail look sick. All right, guys. So then we're gonna go to Google Chrome and go to Google Images. Here we can find a lot of them. I'm just gonna type in sunburst background. These backgrounds look sick. If you guys don't know, like for example, that one looks dope right there. Looks cool. What we're gonna do is we need to get a big file size image, which will, that means like if you stretch it out, it's not gonna get pixelated. So we're gonna do tools and then go to styles and make it large. And it's gonna, now Google automatically optimizes it to show us just the large images. Like this one is pretty large and that looks pretty neat. I don't know if I should use this one. Okay, we'll just use this one because it has a red and white background. So I'm just click open in a new tab, and then it should open it right here. And then you're gonna click save image as and save it to your desktop. For right now, I'm just gonna create a folder to make it a little organized, and I'm gonna call it thumbnail video. And then we're gonna open it inside of that, and we're gonna click save. And now that's saved, we can open it up in our paint.net. Okay, in paint.net, go to file, go to open, and then we're going to find the folder. It's gonna be called thumbnail. Should be on desktop, right here. Thumbnail folder, why can I not find it? Right there, thumbnail video. And here we have the folder, just open it up, and we have our background itself. That's pretty cool. All right. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do Control A, and we're gonna do Control C. Then we're gonna go to the thing we made, and we're gonna do Control V. And we're gonna keep canvas size. What this will do is we're just gonna not make the thing better, because we want this size to stay the same. Then we're gonna click keep canvas size, and now we can reposition this to where it needs to fit. I know it's kind of like shaking a little, like you can see the thing, it's because of my computer. That's okay. And then click enter. It looks pretty centered, and that looks good. Okay, now that we have that, we're gonna add our text. So we're gonna click on this thing on layer, so it's gonna be called add a new layer. We're gonna click on that, and here we're gonna add a text. So just go to the tools on the left right here, and then find the text option. Then we're gonna choose a font, and there's so many fonts that's already we already have on our computer, but I like this one. It's called Captain American or American Captain, never mind. And then it should be over here. And then it should be over right there. So here, what we can do is we can add our own text. That looks really nice. We're gonna make it like 144, and we're gonna type how to make a thumbnail, make a how to make a thumbnail, and then we're gonna probably have a YouTube sign right there, and that looks really good, guys. But I'm gonna probably change it to a white color. Maybe that looks a little too much. Okay, we're probably gonna add a gradient, which you didn't know, it's like a rainbowish. Let me show you. So choose two colors that you would like. I'm probably gonna go with a red and a black. That looks good. Too much of a red, I don't want it to blend in. I'm gonna go with orange and black. Okay, once you've chosen that, then go to the tools and go to gradient. Click on that. And then now what we're gonna do, never mind, go to the tools and go to the magic wand, click on that, and then what you're gonna do is hold control on your keyboard and select the H-O-W-T-O, all the letters that you want it to look in gradient. T-H-U-M-B-N-A-I-L. Okay, once you've chosen all of it, then you guys can let go of the control. Then you guys are gonna go into gradient and just, you're gonna hold your, and then you guys can do this. This will make the thumbnail look sick. You guys can see, give it a nice touch. Or you guys can change it right away right here. I think I'm gonna make it a little like yellow and orange. Orange. That looks sweet right there. Like a lot of YouTubers do this. So they do a bright color on top, and for some reason I can't get this to work. Okay, that looks good. I'm then just gonna click enter, and then okay, that looks sweet. But you don't see it like popping out, like it's so flat on the picture that it looks so bad. But what we're gonna do is go to effects, make sure that layer is selected, because we're just gonna make that one a little pop out. Go to effects and go to the photo and go to glow, and here we can do the radius a little high and make the brightness all the way down, go to the contrast all the way up. Now we can see the picture already popping out. We can also change the brightness to a little higher, but looks kinda bad. Change the radius. I don't really know, but I like to keep the contrast and radius all the way up and click OK. And go to effect and go to repeat glow. And this will also make it a little more pop out. Looks so good on the picture. Then what we're gonna do is, I think I'm gonna add a YouTube sign right here. So we're gonna do another layer. And then I'm gonna go on YouTube. I mean, not on YouTube. I'm gonna go on this, and I'm just gonna look up YouTube logo PNG. Here we have YouTube logo right there. I'm just gonna do YouTube PNG. Let's see what that comes up. Okay, here we have a bunch of them. Come on, give me a PNG one. Okay, this one is pretty good. I think I'm just gonna use this one. Right click, save image as, and we're gonna save it to the desktop, the thumbnail video one, and then click save. Okay, now that's saved. We can minimize this, go back to paint.net. We're gonna go file, open, and we're gonna go to the folder thumbnail video and open up the picture. It's not that hard, guys. Then once we have this, do Control A, select everything, Control C, and then we're gonna go back to the picture we made here. Make sure we have it in a new layer, because we want it to like stay in here. We're gonna do Control V. You're gonna click keep canvas size always, guys, because we don't want the background to be big. I know this is like so huge, but hold shift down and then find the thing you can drag onto, make it a little smaller, and make it a little bit more smaller. Oh my god. And I think that's pretty good. And that should pop out right there. Then once we do that, we can just position it in the right position that you like, and we're gonna click enter. And here is something really cool we can do. Go to photo. We can do the same thing here to glow. And we can make the brightness a little better on this one, I would say. Make it a little better. Oh, see, it does that thing, the white thing. So I'm gonna pop out a little bit more on this. A little bit more. And that should look good. So we can see this actually pops it out on that thing. And now we're gonna add another thing. I'm gonna add a mouse cursor, like clicking on it. So I'm just gonna do mouse cursor. PNG. I think I should find it. Like that one. This one. Why should I like finding this? Something PNG would look good. Okay, I found one right here. I think this looks really good. This one. And then we're gonna click file, save image as, and go to the same thing that we did it on, desktop, thumbnail video, save. We're gonna go back to the file, paint.net, go to open, and then open up the cursor, click open. Same thing, guys, control A, control C, go back to the thing we made over here and make a new layer, and then control V, keep canvas size that I like we did before, and then now it's huge. I know, same thing, make it small. Okay, now that it's actually small, what we can do is we can rotate this, just hover over here, and we can make it look like it's clicking on the thing, and that looks like a really good thumbnail to me. And then click enter. And guys, I'm gonna show you something really cool that I always do. Go to effects, and you guys won't find this, but you can make a bevel, you can make the depth, like you guys can give it a little effects, which you need a plugin to install. Make sure to comment down below if you guys want me to make a video on how to install the plugins. But then just click okay. It's gonna bevel that object, make it look a little bit more cleaner. And then you guys can also add so many options on the new plugin. Add an outline like this, like red, but which we don't really get on the normal thing. I'll show you guys how to get it. But right now I'm just gonna leave it like that. Then I'm gonna show you guys how to add a border. It's really simple too. Just click the plus, and then we're gonna click on the shapes. We're gonna go to shapes right here, go to the tool, go to shapes, and then find a normal rectangle would be good enough. Just click on that, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go let's just do this. You guys can change the color. I'm just gonna change it to black. Yeah, let's go to grayish color, and then I'm gonna make try to fit it in. Okay, something like that. Something that's just okay. Oh crap, I suck at this. Okay, then we're gonna make the size a little bigger, a little fatter, so this fits the thing. Okay, now that it fits this, we can go to effects, make sure the thing, the border is on another layer, so we can add a nice, what is this called, like a destroyed thing. So just go to blurs and make this a motion blur, so we can give it like a distance, just give it a lot of distance, so you guys can see, like, there's like an effect of it going inside. We can do that, or you guys can go to destroyed and make this bulge out like that, or you guys can go to effects and okay, screw this. I'm gonna go to blur and just add a motion blur. Okay, that's, I think that looks good. I'm gonna reselect the untick the centered and then make it like all pop out. And then I'm just gonna click OK. And that should do it. Okay, and then now I'm just gonna go to tool. It's gonna move this because, you know, I made it really bad. And that should give it, guys, a little bit of a more effect on the thing. Like so, but I positioned it so bad. I'm really sorry, guys. So yeah, and that is how you guys make a really nice thumbnail with like some edges, and just, this looks really good to me, in my opinion. And so yeah, if you guys really want the background to pop out, you guys can go to effects, and I can probably just make this a Gaussian blur to make it a little like a blurred out, so you guys don't have to see the thing, not that much. And that should be awesome looking thumbnail right there. Then just go to file, go to save as, and then just save to your desktop. It's really easy. And this, make it a PNG, guys, that always works for me. I'm just gonna name it thumbnail one. Okay, fine, just click save. And here, for me, you guys, I always choose 8-bit, and that works for me, because it always says my thumbnails are big size. Just use 8-bit. It's not gonna make a big difference, but 32 is gonna look a lot clearer. And, but for me, 8-bit works. Just try it out, guys. Look, because this 1.1 megabyte, I'm just gonna save it as 32-bit, and click flatten, and boom. And now it's saved. It should be saved on your desktop right there. As we can see, we just open it up and it looks awesome, nice looking. And I'm gonna also save it as an 8-bit because I don't know, it always messes it up. And no, I'm gonna make this called 21 because, you know, that's different. Make it an 8-bit too. Click OK. Okay, guys, now that you have saved your thumbnail, it should, I have two ones because I made it on 8-bit and a 32-bit. Once you have done that, just go on YouTube and upload it and have fun, dudes. Thank you for watching today's video. Hope you liked it, and I'll see you on my next one. Peace out.